Hello guys, welcome again, it's Vikram Singh and you're watching AI Venture. Today I have something to share with you guys. From now onward, we and I start Python the series of basics over this channel. And in this series, we are deals with everything from the pretty basic. If you're a newbie, you're a mid-level, or you're trying to switch from Python 2 to Python 3, this series will surely help you. I'm pretty excited by the way guys. So before starting this series, let me clear out one of the biggest confusion that most developer or beginners suffer when they start with Python. Do you have any idea what I'm talking about? Obviously, I'm talking about Python 2 versus Python 3. One of the biggest confusion among Python developers. Let me share my side story. When I begin with Python, I do struggle a lot among choosing one of them. To clear out my confusion, I go through countless number of blogs and watch many YouTube videos. Instead of clearing my doubt, I think all that increased my doubt more and I'm getting more confused. But after doing all that research, I came through one question that everyone is talking about, and it is everyone saying that Python 3 is lacking of documentation and libraries, and that thing makes me scared, and that's why I go for Python 2 over that period of time. But now it's 2018 guys, there's no more question like lacking of libraries or documentation exists anymore. So I think for you guys it's a clear cut go for Python 3. Because the creators of Python said that there is no more further development is going to be happen in Python 2. Most of the development is going to be happen in Python 3. Means that Python 2 is going to be a legacy version and Python 3 is going to be a present and future. But do you really think why there is a need of one more version? Even one version is doing very well. To answer that question, Python creators gave many reasons, and today we are going to talk about three major modifications that Python developers are talking about. And the first one is print. In Python 2, the print is used to be a statement, while in Python 3, it turns out to be as a function. And second one is, in Python 2, you can perform one particular task in more than one ways. And third one is integer division. Hang on, we're going to talk everything practically. So let's go to a Python editor and check out what changes are really happening. As you guys see over here right now, I installed both of the versions, both the Python version, Python 2.7 and Python 3.6. Okay, to just show you that what changes the creator really bring in both versions. So it's not necessary for you guys that you to install both of the versions, you can go for Python 3. And over here right now, in the screen right now, you can see I'm running both editors side by side so that we can really feel the changes, what changes the creator really bring in those versions. And the first step, we talk about print function. So let me show you what print function really is in Python 2 and Python 3. So print function is used as a statement in Python 2. Let me show you what it really means. So we say, hello, this is a venture. And when hit the enter, and it prints. While in case of Python 3, it's not act as a statement. It turns out to be as a function. Let me show why. Okay. See guys, it's gonna show you the syntax error because this. See guys, it shows syntax error because this feature is not available in Python 3. In Python 3, print is used as a function. What I mean? Okay, let me show what I mean. See, there's no more error in right now. But do you really think what is the need of changing a statement to a function? Basically, the Python creators said that in Python 2, print function is not that very Pythonic. Let me show what they really mean. Okay, if we want to print more than one thing, that okay, we want to print something different, like and we want to print another statement, and so we have to include a comma and then include that statement, like okay, when we enter it prints. They said this way of printing the function is not that very Pythonic, so they turned it to be into a different one, like print and say and they said they include an and statement because it's a function, and with okay, they said this is more in Python 3, the way of printing is more Python compared to Python 2. Let me show you more changes what Python creators really bring in Python 2 and Python 3. Then the second one that Python creators are talking about, that you can perform one particular task in more than one ways. And what they are talking, okay, let me show you right now. In Python 2, you can iterate over a range in two ways. Like suppose See, we're gonna iterate through that range 10 using range function, and next we can do that very same way by using xrange. Like for I in xrange, see, it's gonna throw the print. But in Python 3, the xrange function is being deprecated. There's only range functions available. Let me show how what I really mean. Over here, you can see that it iterates to a range of 10, but xrange is not gonna work in Python 3. Let me show xrange is not gonna work in Python 3. Let's go and check it out. It shows that xrange is not defined because it has been deprecated in Python 3. It's only available for Python 2. And the last thing that we talk about, integer division. In Python 2, when you divide an integer with a sum another integer, it only shows the int value, not a float value. So let me show what I mean really. See, okay, we're gonna divide 5 by using 2. As you see here, over here right now in Python 2, it throws only 2, means the integer value, not the float value. While in case of Python 2, if you divide same thing, you see it 2.5. That's really Pythonic bit. That really makes us feel. But I like that change very well because it really makes some kind of sense right now. Hopefully I clarify most of your doubt regarding Python 2 versus Python 3. If you still have some kind of doubt, please feel free to put them in the comment section. And thanks for watching, guys. If you like the video, hit the like button, share with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe to AI Venture. And now I'm gonna go to prepare Python series further for you guys.